Dear students, once again, today I am in front of you for further study of social science of standard 10, the chapter nationalism. कल तक आपको मैंने बताया था कि nationalism क्या है और world में nationalism का क्या मतलब है. Nationalism की expansion और beginning किस प्रकार से हुई and what was the important contribution of the France for expanding the nationalism in whole world. Dear students, furtherly, today I will discuss you the very first topic of this chapter, that is what were the different changing happened during the French Revolution. Most importantly, it is necessary for all of our students to take a pen or pencil and notebook and note down these different points, which is very important. What are the different changes that happened during the French Revolution? First point is power transfer from monarch to common people. In this point, you will see that, and you have also studied in standard 9, that the important thing that happened after new government, after the French Revolution, was the power just transferred from the monarchical ruling to democratic ruling. The second changing that happened during this period was new flag was introduced. The third changing that happened, that was the French became the national language. Earlier in different regions of the France where there were different other languages was spoken, instead of this one common language, French language was introduced as national language. The next changing that happened, a new national anthem composed and new oath will be taken. Next changing that happened, the state general elected by the common people and renamed National Assembly. The meaning to say that where there was the ruling system in which the rulers and his son was the next ruler, this system was dismissed and in place of this system, a new system of elected general system was introduced and the court was renamed as National Assembly. The next changing that was very crucial, that whatever the different custom duties and that was the different for the different places, on that place there was one uniform internal custom duties was introduced, means a new system of custom duties was introduced and all earlier custom duties was abolished. The next was the it was the thinking for the peoples in the government that whatever the issues of the nationalism that was just forcing in France to be expanded around the world, so the different peoples or the revolutionaries regarding or belonging to the present government, now they were just expanding the message of nationalism in whole Europe. Now it is very important, which I explained in last video, that the role of Napoleon. In very short, once again, I would like to tell something about him, what were the different changing was done and how he became so much popular. As you know, in 1799, the Napoleon was coming in power, and when Napoleon just comes out in the power, what he did, firstly, earlier ruling was completely destroyed, means once again democratic ruling was abolished, and in place of democratic ruling, dictatorship ruling was introduced. The most important steps that was taken by Napoleon, that was milestones for France, was firstly established equality before law, second right to property, third feudal system was abolished, fourth steps that was taken by him, freed all peasants from the serfdom. The next guild restrictions were removed, and transport and communication system was reformed. These all points are, or and these all reformative actions are known as Napoleon Code. And due to these steps and due to these code, Napoleon became popular, since he was a dictatorship ruling, but being a dictatorship ruling, due to following these steps, he became very popular among the people. There was not only the right steps which was taken by him. Apart from the right steps, there are some drawbacks of his ruling also, and all these drawbacks are, first, the increased tax. As for increasing the income of the treasury, Napoleon just introduced new taxes over the common people, and people were not in this situation that they can pay such taxes. So people were not happy. Second, most importantly, the steps was taken by the censorship. My dear students, you know very well what is the meaning of the dictatorship. In very details, you have furtherly studied in standard 9.9 that censorship means the right to speech, the right of media was completely banned. Means the media or any people, whatever he wants, cannot say about the government and his steps. So there should not be any opposition and against the ruling. That's why the censorship was introduced by Napoleon, because Napoleon wanted that there should not be any one oppositors either in their ruling or around their ruling. So censorship was introduced. Next, next step, what the actions was taken by Napoleon, that he wanted to be the superpower and wanted to be acquired whole Europe. The, in this context, for increasing the power of their army, he started to join the common people forcefully and into the army. This step was not good, and people were not happy with this step of Napoleon. In very short, कुछ लाइन में मैं नेपोलियन के जो सही कदम थे और जो बुरे कदम थे जिसके लिए नेपोलियन जाना जाता है उसको मैं आपको बताना चाहूँगा. नेपोलियन कोड जो 1804 ईस्वी में लाया गया, उसने सबसे पहले कानून के सामने में सभी को बराबरी का अधिकार दे दिया, लोगों को प्रॉपर्टी की अधिकार दे दी. फ्यूडल सिस्टम जो था, जो किसानों को अलग अलग बहुत सारे टैक्सेस देने होते थे, उस सिस्टम को ख़त्म कर दिया गया. सामंतवादी व्यवस्था पूरी तरह से ख़त्म कर दी गई, और जो ज़बरदस्ती गुलाम की तरह किसान जीवन जिया करते थे, उस सिस्टम को भी उसने ख़त्म कर दिया. इसके बाद गिल्ड रिस्ट्रिक्शन, बहुत अलग अलग तरह की जो करेंसीज थी फ्रांस में, उसको उसने ख़त्म कर दिया. इसके साथ ही जो नेपोलियन के रूलिंग में फ्रांस में जो सबसे बेहतर सुधार हुआ, उस समय का ट्रांसपोर्टेशन और कम्युनिकेशन सिस्टम, इन दोनों सिस्टम में बहुत ज़्यादा सुधार किया गया, जिसके कारण से फ्रांस की आर्थिक व्यवस्था में काफ़ी सुधार आई, व्यवसाय काफ़ी तेजी से बढ़ा, जिसके कारण से लोगों में गरीबी दूर हुआ. इन सभी कारणों के कारण नेपोलियन जो है वह फ्रांस में एक तानाशाही शासक होते हुए भी काफ़ी प्रसिद्ध हुआ. इन सभी पॉइंट के साथ साथ मैं ये भी आपको बताना चाहूँगा कि कुछ कदम जो नेपोलियन के थे, जिसके कारण से लोगों की काफ़ी समस्याओं का सामना करना पड़ा, वो जो पॉइंट्स था, सबसे पहले नेपोलियन ने राजा के संपत्ति को बढ़ाने के लिए और ट्रेजरी को बढ़ाने के लिए बहुत सारे नए टैक्सेस को लागू कर दिया। दूसरी बात, मीडिया पर पूरी तरह से बैन लगा दी गई। एक कॉमन पीपल और मीडिया और कोई भी राज दरबार में नेपोलियन के अगेंस्ट में कोई कुछ नहीं बोल सकता हो, इसलिए सेंसरशिप को उसने इंट्रोड्यूस किया। और तीसरा जो महत्वपूर्ण कदम, उसको विश्व विजेता बनने के लिए का जो सपना था, वह चाहता था कि केवल पूरा यूरोप नहीं पूरे विश्व का वो राजा बने। इस क्रम में अपने सेना शक्ति को मजबूत बनाने के लिए उसने जबरदस्ती लोगों को आर्मी में ज्वाइन कराने के लिए मजबूर करने लगा, जो कि लोगों को सही रूप से पसंद नहीं आया। तो मेरे प्यारे बच्चे, मेरे टेंथ के प्यारे बच्चों, आज के इस वीडियो में इतना ही। आपको नेपोलियन कोड और उनके ड्रॉबैक्स के बारे में मैंने बताया। अगर आपको कोई समस्या हो तो मेरे निजी नंबर 8210-320-497 पर कॉल करके जानकारी ले सकते हैं। आज का दिन आपका शुभ रहे और आशा करते हैं कि आपको हमारे विद्यालय के इस कदम से आपको फ़ायदा पहुंचेगी और आप बेहतर करेंगे। और इंतज़ार कीजिए, एक बार फिर मैं अगले टॉपिक में इस चैप्टर का टॉपिक 2 को लेकर के हम अगले वीडियो में आपके सामने फिर से हाजिर होंगे। आपका दिन शुभ रहे। थैंक यू। हैव अ नाइस डे। थैंक यू।